what's wrong with this picture? And your first instinct might be a lot, and you'd be right. But there is method behind my madness. I have decided that I'm going to run the Mid Sussex Triathlon on the 10th of June, which involves swimming for 400 metres.
Swimming!
Running for 5 kilometres.
Running!
And cycling for 22.5 kilometres.
Cycling!
But there's a catch. At the moment, I can't ride a bike. Now, whatever the reasons behind why I can't ride a bike at the moment are irrelevant. The most important thing is that I'm taking action. But we're going to get to that a little bit later. First of all, we need to deal with the fact that I'm also pretty rubbish at swimming. So I went along to Ardingly College, they have a swimming pool there, and I brought Joseph along to give me a bit of moral support, a bit of ridicule, whatever I needed at the moment, to be honest.
Question I have is that, well, swimming you struggle with, and riding a bike you cannot. So can we call this training or just wasted exercise?
I would say intense training. Obviously the swimming starts tonight, and as he said, I'm not the best swimmer in the world, but for now I've got to try and make sure I actually breathe and swim at the same time. Those two things have got to happen, really.
Yeah, I'd recommend breathing. Show us what you look like with the goggles on. This is just for you, ladies and gentlemen. This is what Jay Legate is going to be looking like for most of this piece. And as you can see, it's special, I'd say.
I'll be a bit wetter sooner or later, though.
I would hope so, yes. So, let's crack on with it, shall we?
I think we should.
Good luck. All right then, so we've just witnessed Jay's first session in the swimming club here, preparation for the triathlon, and how'd you find it, mate?
I'm very, very tired. I don't think I've been that tired. I can't remember the last time. Swimming takes it out of you, it's ridiculous. I mean, considering I've been running for a while now, a couple of years, you don't get knackered like you do in a pool, so... Oh, I know I've got a lot of work to do before June, a lot of work.
Well, I thought you did well, mate. I thought that was very good. I thought at the end there, you definitely showed improvement, and you were swimming for what, an hour? Over an hour?
An hour, yeah. At 10 to 9 this evening, I managed...
We're pointing at a clock, by the way. We're just not pointing at the sky.
I managed to get the whole way down the length of the pool without taking in any water, without gulping in any dry airs. I wasn't going, like I had been for pretty much the first half an hour. So I feel much better, basically. So, as it stands, this is my second bout of swimming, and I feel like it's a very long way until June.
Yeah.
What words of encouragement can you offer me at this stage?
Words of encouragement, the way you're swimming. get some scuba gear.
I've heard armbands might be necessary.
Armbands, very handy, yeah. Armbands, floats, get some kids to swim up and down with you. It might help you along.
A bit of motivation. Yeah. So, considering that I feel like I've come a long way in the last sort of two lessons. It does feel like there's an awful long way to go though between what I'm doing at the moment and swimming non-stop for 400 metres.
It seemed like it, but it'll come one day. You'll be able to swim 300 metres, and then 300 metres, 400 metres is only another minute. You'll be there before you know it. It'll come so quick. And it's only your second swim, so look how much you've done in two swims. Imagine how much you've done in 10 swims.
Now, Steve doesn't know me very well yet, and I reckon it might take a few more than 10 swims for me to properly get the hang of it. But enough of me spluttering and floundering around in a pool. It's time to move on to something I know a bit more about, and that's running. And after two swims in a week for me, and Joseph preparing a 10K run for Sports Relief, we went along to Hove Park to work on our fitness. So, me and Joseph are here in Hove Park for the third leg of my weekly triathlon training. And what stage are you at in yours, Joseph?
Sorry, I can't hear you. This is my third run of the week, and this is the Sunday one is the long one. So this is going to have to be my best one so far.
This is the big one.
This is the big one, yeah, of the week. I have to push myself today.
So we're going to be aiming, I mean, I'm going to be doing 3 miles as well. That's what I'm aiming for, hopefully with a bit of a sprint finish. That would be nice. But we'll see how that goes. We'll see how it feels. It's looking a bit hilly around here, actually.
I know, yeah. I'm not quite sure. It's not entirely flat, so which is a bit of a shame. But it's probably the easiest one to kind of get your distances right, which is good.
I've already got my very fetching red headphones in, ready to go. These are sport headphones. It said so on the packet. Oh, look, you've got one of those things as well. Does that actually help?
This thing is...
Joseph Gunn isn't actually flashing his guns. He's showing his arm strap, which is apparently going to help him with this particular event.
This particular device here keeps my iPod on the arm, and it tells me how far I've run, which is amazing.
That is amazing. We've done a bit of a warm-up already. How did you find that? You feel a bit rusty? How do you feel? Quite ready, quite limber?
Fairly limber, yeah. More limber than I did the other two runs, which is pretty promising. So, yeah, not too bad. How do you feel?
I feel okay, actually. It's been the last training I did, or any training I did, was on Wednesday. So it's going to be interesting. That was when I nearly died in the swimming pool for the third time in the last, 2 weeks. So I think it's time I get going.
Good luck, son.
All right, I'll see you in a bit.
See you on the other side. So yeah, Jay's off and running now, and once he's gone ahead a bit, because I don't really like him that much, so I don't really want to run with him, to be honest with you, so I'll let him go on, and then I'll keep to myself in a minute.
Okay, so I've just done what I've been told is in excess of 3 miles. I felt absolutely knackered. It starts off with a really hilly bit at first, and that's the hardest bit to go up, and then you've got a bit of a downhill run, so that's kind of evens it out a little bit. And then once I got into the second lap of the whole place, I started to get a really bad stitch, and I didn't want to stop, so I just kind of kept going. Eventually the stitch just went away. I was thinking the whole time about doing the sprint finish, and when I got to sort of about 100 or so yards away, I thought, I think I do have enough left to be able to do it, and it felt okay actually, but I felt absolutely dead when I finished. But clearly moving in the right direction. It's just a question now of combining it with the other two things of cycling and swimming, so that's the next step.
Now, having never seen myself run before, I had no idea I looked like some kind of broken windmill. I'll be tucking those arms in next time, don't you worry about that. Now, I haven't just done this to open myself up to ridicule. There is a reason why I'm doing it. I've decided that I'm going to raise money for the Rocking Horse Children's Charity, who do some fantastic work in Sussex and Surrey for children who are disabled and suffering from various different kinds of illnesses. So please give what you can at www.justgiving/j-legate. And I'll see you next week when I'll be wearing some more clothes.